this, give them a place to dig, and also make sure that they can't dig their way out of the enclosure. Make sure the water is always available, but that they can easily get out of the water. They can swim, but they aren't great at it, and they aren't great at climbing either, so drowning is a real concern. They can survive a trip to the moon and back, but they can't spend much time in the water. I want to take a moment just to say thank you to our rad fans and stinking rad requirements of tortoises they should do, supporting us on Patreon. Thanks again. When it comes to hardiness, we give the not Russian Russian tortoise a score of 5 out of 5. If you give them the basic requirements of tortoises, they should do really well. Tortoises are hardy, and these guys should live for many decades. Most of the bigger not Russian Russian tortoises that you see are imports. It is probably best to not support this if at all possible. Get a captive bred baby like this one. Heck, if you want a tiny tortoise, why not get a really tiny, tiny tortoise? A really tiny, tiny, not Russian, Russian tortoise. Such a tortoise should realistically live many decades. It will cost a bit more, but it is better for the species, more likely to survive, and still only a few dollars a year if you think about it. When it comes to availability, we give the not Russian, Russian tortoise a score of 4 out of 5. Okay. I'm a little bit conflicted about what to tell you here. If you want an import, they're everywhere. They're in pet stores, expos, and online. Everywhere that sells reptiles, pretty much. If it isn't a tiny, tiny non-Russian Russian tortoise, then it is almost certainly an import non-Russian Russian tortoise. But how long is that sustainable? Captive bred non-Russian Russian tortoises like these are much less common, but they are out there. You'll just need to find a breeder, probably online. But do it! They're healthier, sustainable, and oh so cute. Support these breeders. They're working with these animals purely out of love for the species. It's hard to compete with imports. When it comes to upfront costs, we give the not Russian Russian tortoise a score of 4 out of 5. A captive bred baby like these will cost you maybe 2 or 3 times more than an import, though deals can be found. Even if you end up paying that much, though, it isn't crazy expensive for a pet that will live for 40 years or more. The rest really won't be too bad. You're going to need a big wooden box. But this is fairly easy to build, even if you're bad at building things. Put in some deep substrate that will hold a burrow, a water bowl that can't be escaped, a basking in UVB lights if it's indoors, a food bowl, some small hides, and bam! You're done. And this is why, overall, we give the Russian tortoise a score of 4.4 out of 5. I'm going to be honest. Tortoises are cute, especially when they eat, and they're fun. But they're not buckets of fun. And a tiny tortoise is pretty much as fun as a giant tortoise without all of the downsides of owning a self-driving bulldozer that doesn't understand clear barriers. So if you want a tortoise, you probably want a captive bred, not Russian, Russian tortoise. It's basically the Aki of tortoises. And if you don't want a tortoise, thanks for watching anyway. As always, like and subscribe, and we hope to see you real soon.
Eat our little minions.
You are so lucky.
Yes, I am.
What? Just now?
Yes.
I soaked all of my before I came. I should have got out of my system.
That's what that noise was. Yeah.
Exactly. But to figure out if the not Russian Russian tortoise is the best pet turtle for you, we need to give it a score based on our fave.
He said it's like...